Hello, this is Craig Mertens. I'm general manager and co-founder of Digital Art Solutions. Welcome to the webcast today. Today's webcast is our brand new introduction of our new sales and marketing kit called Graphics Builder. And Graphics Builder is kind of exciting to be talking about Graphics Builder. This has been a big part of my life for the last 6 months. As many of you well know, Digital Art Solutions was acquired by Inksoft Corporation last June. And this is the first traditional product that we produced in collaboration with our new family at Inksoft. The actual first product line we did was our Graphics Plus membership program, but this is the first real marketing kit, toolkit product that we produced together. And this has been a very challenging product to build, because the concept behind this is we wanted to recreate the concept of working with custom graphics. And from my experience, and I'll share this, there's three different ways that customers typically interact with end users in terms of producing artwork, okay? So way number one is customer comes to them and they have their own artwork and you're reproducing it, which, you know, is an important part of our business. But let's be honest, if you're just reproducing somebody else's artwork, they can take that to anybody. And in the day of the internet, it's easy for them to go online, do a search, and find somebody else to print that for them. So we want that business, but that business is a bit easy come, easy go. You know, holding on to that business, at some point in time, it actually becomes a commodity. And so it's a little bit challenging. Then the other part of the business is, you know, the customer has a vague idea of what they want. And the way our Digital Art Solutions customers are trained is, hey, we have stock graphics. We can steer them into online catalog of stock graphics, like these are stock graphics down here. And the customer can say, hey, I like that design, and I'd like you to, you know, modify that and mock that up for me with my colors and my logo and my verbiage in there. Maybe tweak it out a little bit. Those are what we call stock designs. And it's very profitable to do stock designs, because you don't have you know, a lot of art production time incorporated into doing that. You're basically playing Mr. Potato Head. But the challenging one, the one that's challenging for all of us, is custom. And the challenge behind custom is this: the customer might have a vague idea of what they want, or maybe they went over onto one of the online t-shirt designer websites and they you know, design something on their own, and they want you to customize this into something that's unique to them. Well, number one, you don't own any of the copyrights to that artwork, so you can't use it. I mean, if you do, you expose yourself to legal liability. Nobody wants to do that. Number two is, it's actually probably more work to regenerate that artwork than it is to just come up with something from scratch. But the third one is the most important one. It's really time consuming to do that. And, you know, every second you spend on art production, there's actually a real cost associated with doing that. And so the custom work has kind of become the bane of the personalization and decorated apparel industry, because that's what customers want, but they have no context for what it takes to do that. The challenge behind Graphics Builder is, we wanted to produce a toolkit that allows you to create custom without the traditional, you know, work. And it's a collaboration tool. The whole concept is, it's a collaboration tool with your customer. It's different than anything we've done in the past, in the respect that in past graphics were, hey, here's a stock design, change the text, football comes out, baseball comes in, change colors, you're done. That really wasn't the intention of Graphics Builder. Graphics Builder is, we're gonna give you all the parts and pieces and elements, and you can literally do limitless combinations to create pure ground up custom graphics. And we're gonna show you how to do that. Something to point out early on, just so people are aware that are watching, the product is fully compatible with both CorelDRAW version X8 or higher and Adobe Creative Cloud. So if you're an Adobe Creative Cloud person and you're using Illustrator, you can edit all these files as well. So what we're looking at here is the catalog for issue one of Graphics Builder. And what you're seeing here is kind of the templates basics. We talk a little bit about what Graphics Builder is. You notice there's a thing here that says Photific. We partnered with Photific, and they actually provided the product blanks, the high resolution photography that we've incorporated into the catalog. And so if you're interested in finding out more about Photific, you can check out their website, and there's a little, a link to their website. It's pretty impressive. So the template basics is, when we're creating what we call a template, which is a live interactive design, we have illustrations, which are the kind of the clip art, and we're exchanging those. We have textures and backgrounds. We have the fonts and the text, and then we have graphical elements. And what we're doing is we're piecing all those together. And believe it or not, if you look at this example right here, this is the same template. It's just modified fonts, different graphical elements. And you'll notice we carry the same color theme throughout these three variations. I'll show you why in a little bit why we did that. And it's because what we're really doing here is we're doing branding. This is a branding exercise. So we're creating artwork that is going to be at a level of what a top design firm does. You know, people that have designers on staff, people that are, you know, at the level of, you know, the big professional sports marketing companies, we're allowing you to produce graphics on that same level. And we're doing that with the tools that are part of Graphics Builder. So if I go to the next page, this is a perfect example of a layout. And you notice here's one of those photific product blanks. What's crazy about these is they're all set up as Photoshop files. And so you can either open them up in Adobe Photoshop, or you can open them up in Corel Photo Paint, and you can edit every layer of this file. You can edit the drop shadows, the garment color, any kind of highlights, the design itself. It's pretty amazing. So it's a more sophisticated product blank versus just a stack image that we grab on the web. And you can go in and manipulate all the layers. It's pretty impressive. So same template with different variable graphic elements. And then what we've done is in the catalog pages, we have called out what the name of the file is, and then we have called out the name of the font, the fonts that are utilized in the template. So you know the name of the fonts, and then we provided the versions. So here's this particular version is lacrosse. This version is a baseball version. This version is a football version. And you notice the color themes are consistent. What we're trying to get the customer doing is looking at color and saying, okay, these are complementary colors. This is what a design might look like in dark. It could be this design. But this is what this design looks like in a dark background, a medium colored background, and a light background. And you will see that in a theme. I'm not going to take you through every catalog page. This is 140 pages. So I don't want to take you through every page, but I just kind of want to give you guys the method to the madness, so to speak. And incidentally, what we're doing right here is we're going through the online hosted catalog that you can use to share with your customers. And so we really designed this as a collaborative tool with your customers. And we want you to share this. We want you to send them a link. We want you to say, hey, this is part of our creative process. And let me send you a link to a couple catalogs. And then we're going to utilize that link to develop a custom graphic for you. And one of the things that I would suggest is, you know, setting up a Google Meet or a Zoom meeting and sitting right with them and trying to understand the concept between what they're trying to develop. This design that you see right here, completely different graphical theme. We went from here into a conservative kind of collegiate design, and over here we're into a retro 80s design with bright colors and 80s type elements. Same concept, interchangeable, and the color theme stays within the graphic. Same thing here. And so the garment is just merely as a placeholder and is kind of showing the end user, like, hey, these are some of the color schemes that are possible. So you could actually go through the pages just to get them set on a color scheme. Well, do you like this scheme? Do you like this scheme? Oh, that's a good color scheme. So let's take that color scheme and let's modify this set of graphics for that scheme. That's the general idea. And you'll notice as you look at the template, this is the same template, and it's pretty obvious it's the same template because we got a similar arcing style. The fonts are different, the clip art's different, and then the way the graphical elements are incorporated into the design are different. There's different numbers of text, but it's the same basic idea. And one of the key things that we're trying to do, and I used to, when I was in a manufacturer's rep, I would call on coaches, and coaches don't oftentimes have a lot of vision. And it was hard to tell a coach, like, hey, this design has a football helmet on it, but we can turn this design into a baseball design, or we can get rid of the baseball and put a mascot in there. And, you know, when you're dealing with small businesses, the same thing. It says you're seeing this cool design with this little, you know, mercury foot here. But, you know, we can put graphic elements from your business in here. And this can be a small business design or an event or a fundraising design. So what we're trying to do is stimulate creativity. And one of the great advantages of collaborating with your customers, they're locked into you. So if somebody goes to an online design your own shirt design website, which you know, people do that, the problem is they can design on that website. It doesn't necessarily mean they're going to purchase for you from you. They can take that design, even though it's illegal to do so, they can shop that design around. And so you send them up there, you're thinking it's really efficient, and basically, you know, they design something on your site and then they're going to shop it around to somebody else. So what we want to do is we want them coming back to us. And I'm not discounting the importance of having a design capability on your website, because it is a wonderful tool for, you know, getting leads, and it is a great tool for getting leads. But if you're doing direct collaboration with them, guess who they have to come through to get the graphic? They got to come through you. They can't get around it. And so I love this particular page. And the reason I love this page is let me kind of show you some of the design philosophy behind this. This old school collegiate with the weathered effect is timeless. And it is something that's popular. It will always be popular. It is a standard in our industry. People connect with it. They relate to it. It's a terrific look. Now you add the stripes and we're into 70s retro over here. You guys see that? So just adding the stripes and just kind of changing the font. Here we've got a 70s retro theme going on. We come over here and now we kind of have a vintage beer label theme going on. Same design. That's the same design elements, just reconfigured into a different version. And that's a theme that you'll see throughout the graphics builder product. It's the theme. Another very strong page. This is more along the lines of a collegiate theme. So, and you'll notice one of the things that you'll see throughout the entire scope of the collections is they are designed to look very different. It's not the same look throughout. The looks are very, very different. And so like you come over here, this handwritten lettering type style right now is very popular. And so we did a whole section of these new fonts with this handwritten lettering, but look how different that template looks with the classic font. And that would actually work really well for embroidery or an applique if you were to utilize that. So just kind of wanted to show you, this is another very strong page here. The online catalog mirrors the offline catalog. The offline catalog is in PDF format, and that's provided to you when you download the product. The product's available as a download. If you are a smart designer owner and you're a member of our Graphics Plus membership program, if you're a standard member, we can just go in and enable that product in your feed, and it'll just show up in your feed. You know, obviously you have to pay for it, but it'll just show up in your feed. If you're not a smart designer user, you can simply download a zip file that has all the content, and the PDF catalog is the offline version of this, and it's actually secured too. So it's a secured catalog. Like, people can't get to the original artwork. But they're also bookmarked. And what's nice about the bookmark is even the online or the offline catalog, if you go to the bookmarks, if you wanted to jump ahead to, like, say, illustrations, here's all the variable, I guess you could call them clip art, that's used throughout the catalog. So if you wanted to get with your customer and say, hey, we can interchange all these different sports icons here, this is a different style of foot, we're winged foot, we're actually asking you to collaborate with your customer. You're sitting with them and you might be discussing the book. And obviously you can mix and match elements from any of your collections, whether they're from your digital art solutions collections or they're from other collections that you have from other people. The whole idea is to be interchangeable. And the net result is, our hope is that no two designs ever look the same. And an even bigger hope is they don't even really resemble the original design. That's our ultimate goal here, is that it's a collaboration tool. It's designed to be custom. So in that same thinking, what we've done is we've provided all the individual design elements and set the elements within the toolkit to be interchangeable as well. So we can swap out elements. And what some people do, they'll just do a ground up design. They'll do completely custom. They'll just take those two arrows. That's all they'll start with. Start typing in text, important clip art, something completely from scratch. But this is your starting point. And so those are your design elements. And then you have all the fonts. So a lot of these fonts they're all Digital Art Solutions fonts. You won't find these from anybody but Digital Art Solutions. But what we did with the fonts, which was kind of cool, is we did a really good variation of traditional fonts, handwritten, scripty, whimsical letters. We did some of what we call our superhero fonts, which are kind of like a comic book style, and then classic collegiate style fonts here. So that you guys have this really good variety of fonts to work with. And if you were to purchase, see, there's 40 fonts in each collection. If you were to purchase any of these fonts, they're $30 a piece to buy these. So these are included with each collection. There's 40 fonts that are unique to DAS that are included with every collection. That seems like a pretty terrific value if you were to ask me. So this is something that we're pretty proud of. Here's one of those superhero fonts, Iron Man right over here. Here's another superhero font over here. So that's what an issue looks like. And the catalogs here are 70 pages, and you can embed these into your website. There's two versions of the catalog. Catalog one is simply the entire catalog with all the fonts and the clip art and illustrations, and catalog two is just the templates. It's up to you. I think I'd be inclined to share the entire catalog, to be honest with you, with the customer, especially if I'm doing collaboration. So that's an idea. So this is issue one, and then this is issue two, and the same concept, but all different artwork. And so exactly the same concept, but the artwork is very different. And what you'll notice, a theme, it's not just sports artwork. So you'll see school themes, you'll see resort themes, you'll see outdoor themes, you'll see themes that are geared towards events, you'll see patriotic themes, you'll see themes that are geared towards the Greek world. What makes that a Greek template is it says fraternity there. And so the idea is to give you guys maximum flexibility. And so we're very, very proud of the product. And one of the things that I'm excited about, I think we really nailed that retail look that's so popular right now. These designs are not theoretical. They're not what we think is going to sell in the marketplace. These are designs that already exist in the marketplace in terms of the style and the type of composition. We've just created fresh new artwork in these kits so you can produce artwork at that same level. And so these are not intended to use as is. You can certainly go and change Harrison Wrestling to Madison Wrestling if you wanted to, but that really isn't the goal here. The goal in here is to go in and actually tweak these and mix and match. And in the world of DJing, it would call it a mashup. So there you go. It's, to me, like, this is like one of the, like, just the perfect template. Really simple, really clean, very readable, nice font selection. This one has a little weathered effect. You get a completely different look by changing the font and going with the flag in here. So there's quite a bit of patriotic artwork that's incorporated into these. And again, we did the same concept by incorporating the illustrations into here, as well as the graphical elements into here, as well as, again, we have fonts. And let's not forget, we have textures in here too. So textures are utilized for doing a weathered effect. So if you want to do a weathered effect. So I just wanted to spend a little bit of time on the catalog. So how is the artwork distributed? How do you get it onto your computer? What do you need in order to edit the files? Let's talk about that for a second. The files, the things that you'll need to edit the files, you're going to either need a copy of Adobe Illustrator Creative Cloud, or you're going to need a copy of CorelDRAW X8 or higher. The reason we did Creative Cloud is with the Creative Cloud version of Adobe Illustrator, there's certain functionality, mainly in the form of what we call styles. And so we can set up the editable elements in the template so you can modify them using styles. That feature isn't supported in early versions of Illustrator. And we recognize that most people that are Adobe users, they're going to have Creative Cloud. And if they don't, that means they have not upgraded in a very long time. So Creative Cloud is the membership-based version of Illustrator. So these are all live text. So you can go in here, and if you want to change this word to the word sports, or change the text, it's all live text. You'd have to install the fonts. You have the ability to go in and change all the colors in here. Everything is completely, you can manipulate anything you want within the design. There is really no limits. It's up to you. And it's standard editing principles that you would use to edit your own graphics if you were using Illustrator and something you created. So we set these up to be edited. So the center is justified. All of these are vector graphics. Text is on a path. All of the elements are grouped, and all of the colors are Pantones. So every color in the design is from the Pantone matching system. So if you're an Illustrator user, you have kind of here's the color palette for that design. You have the keys to the kingdom. You can go in and manually edit all these designs and literally create limitless possibilities. You can do different artboards and match up elements within the artboards and swap out clip art and all that stuff. You can do the same thing in CorelDRAW as well, but in CorelDRAW, it's a little different. Most of our CorelDRAW users are using our Smart Designer add-on software for CorelDRAW. So what you're seeing on your screen here, you are seeing CorelDRAW version 2020, but there is an extra set of functionality over here in CorelDRAW, and this is called Smart Designer. This is our add-on software for Corel. And I'll show you something that's kind of unique that we can do with these templates that we designed it this way. So I'll kind of explain the theory of how we designed it. But the way you would get the artwork into your system would be as follows. If you are a Graphics Plus standard membership, your software is delivered to you through your membership. So you pay your monthly membership fee, the software is available during your membership. And in the standard membership, you have a little button here. It says subscriptions and updates. If you click on the little subscriptions and updates, it says, hey, I'm subscribed. And if you click on the download manager, any artwork that is currently being fed to you because of your membership will show up in your download manager. So if you purchase the graphics builder group, what we do is we go into our administrative console. We say, hey, this customer purchased the graphics builder product. And we enable that file and it will just show up in your feed. You'll get a little notification and it'll say new content available. And then what you'll do is you'll simply go over here. You'll click on that button. You'll click down. Actually, you could click on both of them if you wanted to. And they'll download and install back to back. And all the issue, once it's downloaded, it will just show up here. This is the backup. This is your zip file. So if you needed to move this onto another computer, you could simply go over here, click on the issue, hit install, and you can install this on another computer that has Smart Designer. So it's very different when you have Smart Designer because we can automatically populate the artwork to you, just like you would in a podcast. It's the same basic theory. We enable that graphics collection, shows up in your feed, and you download it. So where does it go once you download it? That's a great question. So let me kind of show you what happens when you download it. Thing number one is built into the Smart Designer software, you have tutorials and PDF files, and you have our PDF reader. And our PDF reader is a little different because it can also, it's also a video player. So if you wanted to, oh, this will be fun. I'll show you something kind of neat. Is if you went into our little video tutorials here, so it says web tutorials, this will go to our YouTube channel and you can actually play a video inside our little viewer. You could also just go to our YouTube channel. But here's the video on editing a template in Adobe Illustrator. And so if you wanted to, right? So you can go through and you can learn how to use styles in Illustrator. Okay, so that's integrated into the training capability of the Smart Designer software. If I go over here to where it says file browser, this is where all of our manuals and graphics collections live in terms of the PDF catalogs for those. So the one I'm interested in is DAS catalogs. Then you notice it says graphics builder right here. And so there's two catalogs. So catalog one is the big one that has everything. And then catalog two is the smaller one. If you're sharing this with a customer and you don't want them to see the fonts and the clip art and all that, this is the one you'd use. So let's just double click on that. And that's going to open up in my default browser, whatever my default PDF reader is. It's all bookmarked. So here's all the bookmarks and customer has access to this, but they can print it, but they have no access to go in and they have no ability to go in on this file and doing any editing. And this is all flattened out into a bitmap. They cannot get to the original files on here. These are all flattened out into bitmaps. So it's a completely secure way to get artwork. You wouldn't probably do it this way. You would typically send the customer to the online lookbook link and you would send them there and then they could you just send them the link and they can flip through it. So that's kind of where the PDF files are coming. So those got installed when we ran, you know, the installer for Smart Designer to do the content manager. They got installed. Okay. So second thing is templates. So I'm going to go over here to templates and I'm going to click on select template. This is what you're going to see here next. This is the all new graphics browser for the new version of Smart Designer. And the new version is called, is just Smart Designer Pro. We don't do like version numbers anymore because it's just continuously updated. Since we went to the membership program, the software is just continuously updated. You have one version and it's always updated, and this is the version that works with Corel 2020. So when we did the 2020 version, we added something called the graphics browser. And so the graphics browser gives you access to all your templates and your clip art. It's a little different because the templates go right here. So when they installed, they went right here. You guys see that? That's where they went. Okay, so you can access them through the browser. Your clip art browser right here, when they installed, they went right here. So here's your graphical elements, here's your illustrations, and here's your textures right there. Okay, and then this last folder right here, this folder is your own artwork if you want to import your own artwork in. And so what is kind of cool in the new graphics browser, you can go to advanced search over here. And if you wanted to go into a category like, say, events, and go into fundraising, okay, these are all every template we've done has been assigned a category and a subcategory. So it's easy to select an artwork by either category or subcategory. That's something that's new. That's something that's exclusive to this new version of Smart Designer that's available through our Graphics Plus membership. You can also go if you want, if you just want to type in, you know, something specific. Let's see, we'll type in horse. And you could either search clip art or you could search templates this way. So all of the artwork and content in Graphics Builder is searchable via keywords, including the design elements. So like a design element, you could type in laurel and all the laurels would show up, or crest and all the crests would show up. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna edit three templates at once. Okay, can you guys handle that? This is gonna be pretty crazy. So if I go into my catalogs here, you know, we can certainly browse through the templates and, you know, pick out a template. And the idea is you don't have to edit these all singularly one at a time. You could edit a template together. And so the templates are all, obviously they're all different styles and very different appearances. And you don't necessarily have to install the group, but you notice that group of templates is showing up on the same line, so to speak. So the ones that I'm interested in is this group right here. I'm interested in that group right there. So I'm gonna drag and drop that right there. So we'll drag and drop that template. We'll drag and drop this template. Okay, and then we'll drag and drop this template. So we've got all three templates there. And then I'm just gonna minimize that. And probably gonna change my page size a little bit. So I'll give myself a nice big page. Okay, and let's just go ahead and kind of line these up together. So we'll put this guy there, this guy will go over here, and this guy will go over here. So I can edit all three of these templates simultaneously. I don't have to edit them individually, because what I want to do is I want to give the customer three options. I want to show them what this is going to look like in a different option. So what we're going to do over here is I'm going to go into the Smart Designer software, and where it says templates, what we're going to do is we're going to click on edit text. The software is going to scan all the text values and the design. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to change the word Washington to Madison. So I'm just going to go over here and highlight the word Washington, and we're going to change all of these simultaneously to Madison. Okay. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to change all these to 2020. So where it says athletic department down here, I just changed that to 2020. Where the 81 is, I'm going to change that to MHS right there. Where department is, I'm going to change that to MHS right there. And we can go in, we're not taking anything away. I can go in here and select, if I want to select an object and move it, I can do that. It's up to me. Okay. So we can do that. Now, this particular template's grouped. So right now what I want to do is just ungroup it so I can get to the individual parts. And when I'm ungrouping this one, don't really want that weathered. In fact, we can add that in later on. So what we're going to do where it says property of, what we're going to do is be back. Oop, gotta know how to spell. Stronger. Okay, so we're going to click on that. Over here where it says fraternity, what we're going to do is say undefeated. Okay, there's that. And then where it says Wildcats down here, I'm going to say stronger. Right there. And then where it says athletic department, together. Okay, you guys see what I'm doing? So, and from here, we're not limited to anything. And so, you know, where it says Spring Rush right here, I'm just going to change that to Eagles. Okay, so that's going to be Eagles. And now we can go in and start tweaking. So we go in here, we're like, eh, don't need that line. That's gone. Don't need that line really. So let's move this line here and let's make that bigger. So let's make that bigger like that, or maybe just squeeze it in to the width of the little thing here. So here's what we're doing. We're creating a fundraising program. So, you know, all the kids and all the people that are involved in schools, you know, they're, you know, those kids aren't playing softball this summer. The kids are, you know, we don't know what's going to happen when schools resume in the fall. So what we're doing is we're creating a fundraising program. So the kids are still involved and active in their, you know, school spirit and their sports. And we're going to utilize this to set up a store so that the parents and loved ones of the kids can buy these shirts to support the kids, and the kids get to wear these with pride and just keep their minds engaged in, you know, the activities they're involved in. That's what we're doing. I can go in here if I want. I can change all the fonts. We can change every single aspect of one of these designs, but let's just kind of keep it simple for now. So we've got the design here, and let's change athletics. Let's go down and we're going to change that to Eagles. There you go. All right, and if we want, we can go crazy. We can go over here if we want to make this bigger, just select it. And right now it's at 32 points. And if we want to make it 72 points, we can do that. If we want to make it 48 points, we can do that too. Oh, I see one thing. We don't want a W in there. We want an M. There you go. So here's our template. So let's go ahead and save that. So we'll go down here and I will just click on save and I'll put that into my little folder here. And we'll call that Madison Eagles. Okay, so next thing we need to do is we can localize the clip art. Pretty easy to do that, a couple different ways. Probably one of the easier ways to do it is in the template functionality, just click on change art. And what we can do is we can isolate the different elements within the design. So we can isolate them. So I've got that element selected. You guys see that? And I'll come over here and I'll just type in Eagle. And we'll hit Eagle. And just kind of word of the wise, you know, if you're going to do a, you know, depending on the production process, so this might be screen printed, it might be DTG, we might sublimate it, we might use a white toner, laser printer. There's a lot of different things that we can use to on this graphic, but it's probably a good idea if you were thinking screen printing to keep the colors down. So I'm not going to pick the one color version of the eagle. I'm not going to pick the five color. I'm just going to pick the two color to kind of keep it down. And so we'll click on that. And if we want to, we can reproportion that, make it bigger. Okay. So the thing that we're going to do next is we're going to recolor this. Now, on this template, there's text on a path. I go to view in wireframe view, you can really see there's text. And we want to keep that because if we're ever going to change the text and the arcing, we need to have that text there. But if we're going to go in and do real detailed manual editing, it's actually to our advantage to get rid of it. And so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go over here. I'm going to right click and say duplicate page and copy all of the contents to another page. And on page two, I'm going to get rid of this text on a path. And two ways I can do it. I can just hold my control key down and just click on it. Or Smart Designer has a feature under object shaping that'll remove all your text on a path control curves. Okay, so let's get rid of that. All right, back to regular view and let's take a look at it. So let's get the colors all handled. And so the way we're going to handle the colors is we've got a little shortcut here. And that's going to go to our modify colors function. So here's all the colors in the design. So a couple different ways we can deal with colors. We can manually recolor this using the swap function, or we could try a reduction as well. And so if we do a reduction, I just basically keep pick the colors I want to keep. So I'm going to keep that burgundy. I'm going to keep this blue, and I'm going to keep one of the golds there. Okay, you see where it says reduce? And we're just going to start knocking it down. It'll start reducing the colors down. And then from here, we can start swapping colors. So if I go over here to swap, one thing I might do is where that gold is, I might want to swap that out with orange. If I uncheck keep tints, if there's a shade of that orange, it'll make it solid. So let's go ahead and just swap that out with orange. I'll use Pantone. That's the default color palette in Smart Designer is Pantone. Whoops, we do want to use that shade thing. So let's go ahead and keep that as a shade. Okay, so that way it maintained the shade of that color. Then on the burgundy, I think what I want to do, I think I want to take those two colors and make those like a navy color. And we'll either love it or hate it. So that's what's so cool about this. We don't really have a lot of investment in changing colors because we're just going to do it all globally. And it looks good. And from here, Corel has been kind enough to create a color palette for us down here as we've created this. So you notice you can also just drag your colors in here. It's real easy to go in and change this. So if I just go down here and click on the blue that we're using, I think that looks better. I think that'll look better as orange. Make that a solid orange. This together should be white in my opinion. This right here should have a blue outline and a white fill. This I think should be white. I don't know, I'm gonna leave it like this. So I have an interesting idea for this. So here's our design. We've got, you know, three custom designs, completely localized, school colors, ready to rock and roll. And if I wanna change this up even more, you know, we've got 100% latitude to modify this. And so a little Corel trick, you just grab the dropper here and we could just sample that color, go like, yo. And then let's see over here. I think I would do the same thing, but let's just steal this guy and move him over and maybe make him bigger. And I think this guy needs to be pretty good size. All right, I'm happy. So there's our three designs. So how are we going to get this in front of the customer? Well, we're going to create a virtual sample. That's what we're going to do. And so to create a virtual sample, we're going to use a feature in Smart Designer to do that. So we're going to use the virtual samples feature. We're just going to say virtual samples, go over here, and let's go and start adding these to products. So I've got all these different products here. I'm in my Sanmar catalog. And so first product, I think I'm just going to do this kind of ash t-shirt here. So this one, I'm just going to select that one and we're going to click on the ash t. So we'll click on that one first. So there's that. Then the next one, we're going to put this on a sweatshirt. So let's go down here and ooh, that would be cool with the soccer ball in there. That'd be pretty awesome. Yeah, way cool. And then this one, I'm just going to go old school. And we're going to do that on this is an interesting one. Yeah, we'd go this route with the basketball on it. Why not? So we could have gone with just like a generic kind of a look. This one right here is set up as a pocket design, but there's no reason that we can't go over here and do it on a different design. So it does, I'm not really crazy about that color. I think I'm gonna use a lighter color, gray. Let's see here. Oh, put on a sweatshirt. So just click on it, click on the sweatshirt. There it is. But this one I wanna do differently because this one I wanna add a weathered effect to this. So a couple things I want to do. I want to click on Madison and I want to recolor this a little bit. I think the Madison part here needs to be blue. And so a little Corel trick, if I hold my shift key down, I can drag and drop color with my right mouse button. And I want to do the M. I want that to be blue too. I'm pretty happy with that. And I want to do a weathered effect. So in Smart Designer, what I'm going to do, I could just go over here to effects and just go in and add a weathered effect to it over here. Or I can do this when it's all done on the product blank. It's up to me. I think I'm going to do it when it's all done because I'm not convinced I want to do a weathered effect here yet. But we'll once we get the catalog page set up, then we'll decide that. So let's go ahead and add this to our layout. So I'm just going to add that virtual sample to my layout right there. So we're going to add that to our layout. And we're going to add this one to our layout. I think I'm going to make that just a little bit smaller. So we'll add this one. And then we'll add the third one, which is this one. And we'll add that to our layout. And what I want to do is I want to create one virtual sample proposal page that has all three of these in it. So all I'm going to do is just say, click on the little button here. It says all. And then I'm just going to create proposal page. And I'm using layout number one right here. It's just a simple one. And so we'll just click on create proposal. So obviously I'm in teaching mode. I'm not in production mode. This is take a fraction of this amount of time when I'm not explaining what I'm doing, when I'm just creating one. So in this case, I put a watermark in here and I can delete that. And let's make this more interesting looking. So let's go ahead and get rid of that. And we'll take this guy over here and we'll put him in the corner. And it's just artwork, make that bigger. We'll take this guy and we'll move that over here like that. And we'll take this one and move it over here like this. And then, you know, you can have paragraph text. So if you want to put some copy in there and pricing in there, you can do that. It's just a flyer. And so the next thing I would do is there's a little box right here. It says convert blanks to bitmaps. When we created this, it automatically converted that to a medium resolution bitmap. So there's no danger of any being able to access that art as it's secure. And then I think this one needs to be a little bigger. There we go. And then what I'm going to do is just going to click right here and we'll create a PDF and I'll throw this into handouts. So we're going to go over here to my little handouts page here. And we're going to call this Madison Eagles Proposal. And what I'm going to do under settings for PDFs, like all kinds of changes we're going to make, but the only change I'm going to make on this, I'm going to put my copyright in here. So that's stamped into the graphic. I'm going to change this to JPEG compression at 70% to reduce my file size. I'm going to downsample my bitmaps to 200. That's just, all that's doing is just reducing my file size. Compress text in line artwork. We're going to compress the file. We can have it convert all the text to curves if we want. And then I can put password security on here so they can't open it or edit it. I will go ahead and put in, I'm not going to put a password on it. I'm just going to leave it unsecured. But it doesn't matter because we converted all these graphics to bitmaps. So I'm just going to hit save. And it is going to save the graphic for me. And once that's saved as a PDF, so the whole concept is we're creating a whole branding program for client, and we're going to propose a fundraising program to them. And that fundraising program is we're going to set up a simple little website for the customer. They can go on that website. We're going to donate a portion of the proceeds from every shirt back to that group. And we are going to utilize this as a tool to generate support and enthusiasm for people that are involved in the school or youth sports. That's the whole concept. So we're using the graphics builder to create a completely customized set of graphics and getting this in front of the customer. That's exactly what we're doing. And so let's go over here and I'll show you what the PDF looks like. Let's see here. I think, did we put it in there or did we put it in downloads? I think we put it in downloads. Oh, right here. Okay, so this is what the PDF is like right here. Okay, so that's the PDF, and I'm going to copy that over to my downloads folder. And here's what we're going to do. If you're on the live webcast, I'm just going to throw that into handouts, and you guys can suck that down right now. So let's go over here to handouts, and you're in the little control panel. If you have the app version, I don't have the web version, I'll let you do this. And then the other way we're going to do it is for the folks on the recording, if you just go to digitalartsolutions.com, click on graphics, me, click on handouts, and I'll just throw that in there so you guys can download that. And the reason I like to show you guys this is this is how we tell you to get ideas in front of your customer. If you are going to attach this into, like, say, a PDF or even a JPEG file into an email, there's a high probability that the customer on the other end, depending, especially if they're a school, that they're never going to see it. It's either going to get picked off by their spam filter or not get delivered. So by incorporating this into a hosted PDF, a web page, all we have to do is just send them the link. That's all we have to do. And this is an extremely professional way to get artwork in front of a customer, because all they have to do is we send them this link right here. They just click on it. They can go over here if they want to comment on it, put a comment in here. Hey, can we do this in a navy blue shirt? They have the ability, you can do approvals. The difference is I'm using a paid account from Hightail. If you go to hightail.com, a free account will let you host this file for six or seven days. And then it disappears. If you have a paid account, you have unlimited storage and you can host it forever and ever. So I could create a page specifically for Madison Eagles and they could see that artwork there. Then from there, what we would do is we would set up, once they were kind of, and this is what a lot of our customers will do. I'll take everybody over to Mark's, one of Mark's pages. So this is a little spirit shop page that Mark Heist set up for his local yellow. So I challenged Mark yesterday. I sent him an email. Mark actually won a copy of, it's pretty funny. So he, at our last trade show, he won a copy of our newest product. Only problem is he owned everything we've ever done. And so he reminded me yesterday, he says, hey, you still owe me that free product from the drawing. And I was like, okay, I'll send you graphics builder. And I had a secondary motivation because I wanted him to test the distribution. So we went and enabled graphics builder in his graphics plus account. And it showed up and he installed it. And he's all excited. So what I challenged Mark to do is I challenged Mark to take the graphics and graphics builder and set up a new store for the different sports and teams and school spirit for Yellow Springs High School. And I don't know. I mean, I'll look at if Mark's on here. I think he is. He can tell us how much money he's generated from this store. And this is an Inksoft store right here. So I don't know what we're up to here, but people can go over here on the store, pick the garment color, pick the sizes. And what he does with these stores is a percentage of profits from this store goes right directly to the customer. So Mark keeps part, customer keeps apart. We're raising money for the school. So when they're back in business and they need to go on to an invitational tournament or they need new supplies or uniforms, we're raising money for those schools. And the secondary benefit is the kids get a really cool t-shirt. The parents get to show support for the kids or for the school. What a incredibly cool. So this store, Mike just chatted me, since January has sold $3,700 since January. And basically just these graphics, two graphics and a multitude of artwork. So it's really quite impressive. So this is exactly the case study of why we developed Graphics Builder. We wanted to give people the ability to do these customized higher end type graphics at retail trends and be able to populate web stores, be able to get ideas in front of customers. If you're not selling online, you can certainly kind of old school this with, you know, PDF flyers and things of that nature, but ultimately utilizing this content within the context of a web store is brilliant. So what I told Mark to do, as I said, set up the store. He doesn't need permission to do it. Set up the store, and then you can utilize the store as a prospecting tool. Before you even, let's say that I wanted to sell to Chaparral High School here in Phoenix, right? are in Scottsdale, where I live. I could set up a store for Chaparral High School, not activate it for e-commerce, just leave it as a static store, not activate it, send a link of that store to the potential buyer, the Booster Club mom, and say, hey, this is what we do. I just want to show you an example of what we do. We're literally one mouse click away from activating this store, and then we're going to pay you XYZ percentage of every transaction sold on your store. And you guys don't have to stock anything or inventory anything. So that's a kind of a next level concept. And so in the context of what's all happening in the United States of America and Canada right now, or really globally, to be able to develop these fundraising programs around Graphics Builder, to me, like I feel like our timing was kind of ideal. And so the concept behind Graphics Builder, I'll kind of share you some of the internal thinking, and tons of thought went into this. I don't want to say way too much thought, but like this was an obsession, because this was a collaborative effort between the entire team. At all levels of the organization, the entire Inksoft development team, the DAS team, our art director team, our graphics team, myself, all the way up to the Inksoft leadership. So one of the things that we did, we completely redesigned this whole catalog kind of concept. I really like the catalog layout in Graphics Builder, and this will be a theme that you'll see carried forward in future products. Also, we designed a nice clean little logo. Very simple, clean little logo. So some of the thoughts and the marketing thoughts before we even started creating this, these were the marketing objectives that were needed to be met to create this graphical toolkit. And so number one, better graphics equals increased sales. Quickly create personalized graphic concepts, present them, and feel confident that you're hitting the mark every time. Speed up the approval and commitment process to secure orders quicker. Start selling smarter. One of the most clunky, inconsistent, challenging things of us as apparel decorators and people that are doing personalization is this whole concept of getting ideas and collaborating with the customers on artwork. It's dysfunctional. It's frustrating. And if we can smooth that out and make that easy for our customers, we've just made it easy for them to buy from us. And then they rely on us for creativity. And it also is an incredible insurance policy against them going to a competitor, correct? So we want to keep them under our roof. That's called retention. So better graphics, it's hard. I know the one of our customers, and they specialize in the church market and the religious market, and their graphics team is amazing. And it would be hard for somebody that's in that world to switch, because they just do such a great job, and they just make cool stuff. And so that's the idea. We're trying to give you a kit to make cool stuff. Number two, reduce costs and keep the profits. Freelance graphic designers are expensive. They are. And they're going to charge you whether the design sells or whether it doesn't mean it's a bad thing, but they're going to charge you whether the design sells or if it flops. You're still going to get the bill. And having an artist on payroll can be expensive as well. We're talking to clients right now today that they're doing the graphics themselves because they've done a staff reduction, and they started doing the graphics themselves, and they're like, hey, wait a minute, I got smart designer and all these great tools from DAS. I can do this myself, and I don't have to have all this excess cost. I'm not saying to fire your designer. It's important if you're at a certain level of business and you're doing a certain level of volume, having a designer on staff is a great thing to have, but it doesn't prevent you from not being successful in the industry. Not having a designer is not going to prevent you from being successful. And the reason for that is you guys have tools from Digital Art Solutions that allow you to be very productive. So Graphics Builder removes those costs from your bottom line, allowing you to generate the best graphics at the lowest cost, right? Cool. Competitive distinction. We fought over this one, what to call it. And the name that we called it was competitive distinction. And I'm happy with the choice we made. Don't just stand out from the competition by offering the lowest price. Stand out by offering the best possible graphics for the widest range of customers, because customers have different tastes and we want to meet them at their taste. So giving them more options. When I was a manufacturer's rep, it was always amazing to me when we were working with customers and developing custom graphics, and we had to use our design team to do that. So and sometimes they would send our lead graphic designer out to Colorado, where I was a rep, and they would travel with me for a week, and we would meet our top customers, and we developed custom graphics for the back to school program. And it was kind of clunky, but man, was it effective, because once you had that customer collaborating with you on the graphics, they were locked into you. And it was very frustrating for my competitors, and I'm pretty sure they hated me for it. I know they did. So with so many styles on the on lock, the graphics builder ensures you'll get it right every time and leave your competition in the dust. This is the great differentiator. This toolkit and this concept that we propose through our graphics, the idea is just to leave your competitors in the dust. Very few people operate at this level. Look, the companies that operate at this level are people like Nike and Adidas and Under Armour. They're operating on this level. So we're giving you tools to operate on that same level. Competitive distinction. Unlock new sales opportunities. With so many different styles, textures, and fonts at the ready, you'll be perfectly positioned to approach and engage more customers than you ever thought possible. Schools, teams, organizations, fashion-forward sororities. You'll have something for everyone. That's why we wanted to create kind of the broad spectrum. So I'll show you something fun and we'll kind of end what's here. You guys are welcome to go to the Graphics Builder webpage, Center Digital Art Solutions. I'll show you there. Just go to Digital Art Solutions, go to products, and then you can go to the Graphics Builder webpage. But I'll show you this. This is kind of my favorite part of Graphics Builder, because this is exactly how we designed it. This is really kind of fun. So if you were to take a template, okay, and you were to use it as a starting point, right? And we'll just find one. We can do something cool. Illustrate the point. A template is just a placeholder waiting for a fresh idea. That's all it is. It's just a placeholder. And you know who provides the fresh idea? You guys do, and your customers do. So if you went into a template and you wanted to modify that template for something completely unique, you would probably have a vague idea of kind of the look you were going for. So maybe the look you were going for was something like this. Okay, that's cool. The little gymnastics, got the tail end in here. You got these graphical elements. So if I click on that template pops up, right? And we can start doing kind of a mashup. So I might want to change the text first. So I'll go to edit text. We'll leave the word Madison there, that's fine, but we're going to change this to basketball. Okay. And in Smart Designer, you have this little T here that'll change that to title case. And we maybe want to change that font. So I'll say DAS Sports. Just start typing it in. And we'll do Sports Script. That's a classic script font. Okay. Right there. So we'll set that up right like that, okay? Then under the word Madison, okay, we can keep that collegiate font, but I wanna do a different version. We'll maybe try stadium font, DAS stadium. And we'll see if we'll either love it or we'll hate it. Not crazy about it. So we'll do DAS sports block. Let's try DAS sports score, which is a very classic font. Simple. Yeah, I like it. All right, so which means we wanted these to sports score. We'll highlight that. And we'll change that to sports score as well. Actually, you could just do it that way. You could just select it. You go right through Corel and do that. Just type in DAS Sports. You can do it that way too. Two ways to do the same thing. So DAS Sports Score. And we have the little design set up. I forgot in Corel, if you click on it, it's going to live change. Okay, so there we go. So we might want to add, you know, some flair to this. Okay, so a couple things is could add a text effect. Okay, I could also, if I grab my shape tool here, look at, I go grab my shape tool, I can spread the characters out. I could select the characters and move them over on the path. I could drag them down on the path, change the individual kerning. So I've got, you know, pretty much the keys to the kingdom here. I'm not taking anything away from Corel. I've got the keys to the kingdom, but what we're doing here is we're creating a kind of a starting point. And so from here, what I want to do is I actually want to get rid of the M and I want to put a basketball in there and I want to use a different graphical element. So this is where having the interchangeable elements works really great. So let me just go down here to clip art and we'll just go to graphics builder and we'll just cruise in here to elements. And let's see, what do we want to do for an element in there? I'm going to do like a diamond shape or something. Let's see, graphical. Oh, yeah, perfect. So I'm just going to use this element. Just going to double click on that. It's going to change that one out. And then where the M is, I'm going to highlight that. And we're going to change that out with the basketball. Let's see here. We'll just use that one. So the basketball goes in there. Maybe make that. No, that's make that whole thing a little bit. Nah. So you guys see what I'm doing? We're playing. Okay. So do I want to have a text effect on Madison? I think I do. So let's go over here and oops, I didn't want to change that font. Let's go over here and let's go to effects and let's go over here to outline effects and smart designer. And let's just apply this effect right here and let's knock the inline color out. So we'll just add that effect. Eh, it's a little too bulky. So let's change this. Let's cut that outline in half and apply that. Perfect. I'm going to drag and drop this color over here. There's that. We're going to drag and drop that color over here. Might as well throw orange in for the basketball. That's cool. Let's go ahead and change that over here. I think I want to globally change the colors out to purple. Let's kind of go with the purple theme. So let's go down here to color management. Here's the colors in the design. So two things. Let's take that color and swap that out with Pantone 123 gold. So let's do that. Oops, I want to do the whole thing in gold. And let's take this and swap that out with purple. Where's that? Looks good. Hey, perfect. So there's our design. So let's step it up a notch and do a weathered effect, right? So let's step it up a notch and do a weathered effect. So I'll just go into Smart Designer. And we'll go back to Effects. We'll go to Overlays Docker. And do like a mesh jersey effect to it. And we'll put a jersey mesh feel to it. And then we're done. That's Graphics Builder. So meanwhile, when you're sitting with your art department and trying to explain what you want, or you're working with a freelancer that's charging you $50, $75 an hour, you're done already. And so that's what we ended up with. This is what we started with. So let's go back to that. And then we can do a little comparison. So a little smart designer feature to say load last template. So that became that. And this is good enough to save. So I'm going to save it as I like it. There you go. This is the part where I drop my mic and walk off. So we're really proud of this. And this product is the culmination of my 28-year career in developing graphics content. It takes a village. Everyone in our organization, from the development team to our art director to our art graphics staff to our programmers to principals of the company, collaborated on this product. This is not a product I could have built myself. This is a product that required a lot of people to put together these ideas back and forth. Just like you guys collaborate with graphics, we collaborated on this whole concept. And so this is the next generation. This is the evolution of production ready digital art. And it's not just a graphical toolkit, it's also a sales and marketing kit. So I'm gonna go ahead and stop the recording and then we can open it up for questions.